Hey, in this tutorial, we're going to take a look at how Impact LXmk3 is set up to work with Logic Pro's Alchemy. The integration is geared towards keyboard players and producers, and there's some particularly unique features when controlling Logic's timeline, mixer, and instruments. Let's start with a look at Alchemy's custom integration. When Alchemy's browser is in view, pressing the up-down arrow buttons together sets them yellow, which enables you to select the next or previous preset. The pads trigger Alchemy's performance pads, so when you find a preset that has the character you are looking for, you can use the pads to audition the variation which works best. It's loads of fun working with the LXmk3 and Alchemy in this way. The pads make a big difference to the overall experience, but most of all, they are great for performance. Now, if you want to record the sound variations from the pads, hold instrument and press record on LXmk3 to turn latch on. Having the performance pads at hand on the LXmk3 really adds a new dimension to the sounds you can produce. Let's start by using Shift and Track on LXmk3 to create a new Alchemy track in Logic. Then we'll use Shift and Instrument to open Alchemy. The controls on Impact LXmk3 are immediately mapped to the most important Alchemy parameters, those in the Simple View. Simple View is the top layer of Alchemy parameters programmed independently for each of the 8 pads. The 8 full resolution encoders control parameters that have the biggest impact on the preset's character. The first 4 faders control the attack, decay, sustain, and release parameters. And finally, faders 5 to 8 control the 2 XY pads. So all the parameters in Simple View are immediately controllable from Impact LXmk3 and across any of the 8 variations, which can be selected from the performance pads in real time. The custom Nektar integration creates a workflow that supports the best of Alchemy and makes exploring sounds creative and, above all, fun. The large dial next to the display is the global dial, and with the select button green, it's going to control the selected track volume in Logic. Such an important control for keyboard-based producers that we put it alongside instrument mode so you don't have to change to mixer mode. Hold down the select button and you have control of the pan. Press the select button to turn it yellow and you have access to the filter cutoff and resonance. Now this is automatically detecting these parameters even if we haven't mapped the instrument at the other end. Hold the button down to access the resonance parameter. With the select button orange, the global dial maps to the last clicked parameter in Logic's selected channel strip. This includes insert effects, sends, the pan and the volume controls, but also crucially, instruments. And in the case of Alchemy, of course, this means that you can have tactile control over any parameter, even the ones hidden in deep modulation layers. By holding down the select button, the secondary mode in this case is fine control, which gives you more than 10 bits of resolution. So there you have it. Of course, we've mapped smart controls, we've mapped mixer parameters, transport, and all the usual stuff, but Nektar's approach to integration gives you so much more, particularly as a keyboard-based producer. Thanks for watching.